Hadith Jibreel is the first hadith you learn when you study. It really is. It's the most important hadith in Islam. It is, by consensus of the scholars, the most important hadith of Islam. It's been narrated by multiple companions with greater context from some of the narrations. The most detailed one is from Abu Dharr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Abu Dharr says, we used to sit with the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and when someone came from outside, they didn't know who amongst us was the Prophet of God. Why? He dressed like we dressed. He sat on the ground like we sat on the ground. He distinguished himself only by his manners. Even when the Prophet ﷺ did the hijrah, when he migrated to Medina, the Ansar didn't know which one was the Prophet ﷺ. Was it him or Abu Bakr? So they're just waiting to see some form of indication as to which one's the Prophet ﷺ. So Abu Bakr took something, a cloth, and he did this. So they all charged the Prophet ﷺ. They didn't know who he was when they came. So outsiders would come expecting to see this powerful man, right? That's sitting on a throne while everyone else sits on the ground. They just saw him sitting with everyone else on the ground. So Abu Dharr says, we insisted the Prophet ﷺ sits on a chair. He refused. Then Abu Dharr says, what we did instead was we pushed the dirt together until we made a mound so that he's still sitting on the ground, but at least when someone comes from outside, they know who he is. He said, the Prophet ﷺ accepted that. When we did that, Abu Dharr says, one day we were sitting and he said, we used to wait for people to come to ask the Prophet ﷺ questions that we were too shy to ask him and we would listen to the answers. So one day we're sitting and suddenly a man appears. And this is how he describes him. He says his thobe was extremely white, not wrinkled. And you know, having an extremely white thobe while walking in the desert of Arabia is a pretty tough task. Okay? No wrinkles, no dirt on it. His hair was exceedingly black. And he said that he smelled amazing. He had the best smell that we'd ever seen. And he said the most perplexing thing about this man, he wasn't a resident because he didn't live amongst us, but he had no signs of travel on him. I mean, he looked as fresh as they come. You know, they didn't have first class travel back then. You don't get off a plane and look fresh if you come off of first class and look miserable if you come off of coach, right? This is the desert of Arabia. So like, we're looking at this guy, no bags under his eyes. He looks really, really clean, really, really good. And we have no idea who he is. And Abu Dharr says he resembled Dihya. So it shows you that he didn't look exactly like Dihya from close up. He wasn't Dihya, he resembled Dihya, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So then Abu Dharr says, the man came and he stopped at the entrance. And he said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, As-salamu alayka ya Muhammad, peace be unto you, O Muhammad. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, wa alaykum as-salam. He said, adnu ya Muhammad, do I have permission to come close to you, O Muhammad? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, sure. Now, they weren't used to this as well because most of the people that came and asked the Prophet ﷺ questions were Bedouins. They didn't have any, they just walked right in, sat in front of the Prophet ﷺ and started asking him questions. So the adab was also flawless, the manners, like, adnu ya Muhammad, should I come close? The Prophet ﷺ said yes. Jibreel came close, he said, should I come closer? The Prophet ﷺ said yes. Until Jibreel was sitting right in front of the Prophet ﷺ and he put his hands on the knees of the Prophet ﷺ. Abu Dharr says the Sahaba huddled around. What's going to happen here? What's he going to ask? So Jibreel says to the Prophet ﷺ, Ya Muhammad, akhbirni anil Islam. Oh Muhammad, tell me about Islam. So the Prophet ﷺ gives him the five pillars of Islam, that you bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is the messenger of Allah, that you establish the prayer, that you pay the zakat, that you fast Ramadan, and do hajj if you're capable of doing hajj. Okay? Now here's the thing. The man says, sadaqt. You've told the truth. Abu Dharr says, we all looked around at each other, وَأَنْكَرْنَا. Like we were like, who do you think you are to say sadaq to the Prophet ﷺ? You've told the truth. What is the arrogance? Like we thought this man had good manners, right? He says to the Prophet ﷺ, you're right, you've told the truth. Then he says, أَخْبِرْنِي عَنِ الْإِيمَانِ. Tell me about faith. The Prophet ﷺ said, to believe in Allah, to believe in the angels, subhanAllah, it's Jibreel sitting in front of him, to believe in the messengers, the messages, the day of judgment, and divine decree. He says, sadaqt. You've told the truth. He said, أَخْبِرْنِي عَنِ الْإِحْسَانِ. Tell me about excellence. The Prophet ﷺ said, "And تَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ كَأَنَّكَ تَرَى, that you worship Allah as if you can worship Him. And when you realize, or as if you can see Him, you worship Allah as if you can see Him. And when you realize you can't see Him, then you know that He sees you." He says, "Sadaqt." Then he asks the Prophet ﷺ the frequently most asked question in the seerah. مَتَ السَّاعَةَ? أَخْبِرْنِي عَنِ السَّاعَةَ. When is the hour? This is the frequently most asked question to the Prophet ﷺ. Everyone wanted to know when the Day of Judgment was. Not the same reason that Idris wanted to know when he would die, right? They just wanted, the mushrikeen, the disbelievers, would ask the Prophet ﷺ mockingly, but with a hint of truth, like, when's the Day of Judgment? When are we going to die, right? So Bedouins would interrupt the Prophet ﷺ, sometimes even in his khutbah, and ask the Prophet ﷺ, "Mata sa'a?" When is the hour? And the Prophet ﷺ, he always gave a productive answer. So he would say in one narration, "Mada addatu laha?" What have you prepared for it? Another narration, "Mada qaddamtu laha?" The same thing. What have you put forth for it? Another narration, he said, "Look, by the time your son has gray hair, you would have already faced your resurrection. So even if the day of judgment doesn't come, death will already come to you. Your resurrection has started as far as you're concerned anyway." But when Jibreel asked him that, what did the Prophet ﷺ do? He put his head down. So Abu Dharr says, we were confused. To make it even more confusing, he said, "Ya Muhammad, akhbirni an as-sa'a," tell me about the hour. The Prophet ﷺ said nothing. He asked him a third time, tell me about the hour. Look at the answer of the Prophet ﷺ. He said, the one who is asking knows very well that the one who's being asked knows no better than the one who's asking. Like, you and I both know that we have no idea when the hour is. You don't know and I don't know. I don't even know why you're asking me that question. And it was to show the companions something, right? So then Jibreel said, well, tell me about its ashrat, tell me about its signs. And the Prophet ﷺ, he mentioned two particular signs of corruption, that a woman would give birth to her master and barefoot Bedouins would start competing to build tall buildings. And he said, sadaqt, you've told the truth. Abu Dharr, and in the narration of Umar as well, he said that the man suddenly left so quickly that we were all confused. And the Prophet ﷺ said, go see if you can find him. So all the Sahaba went around looking for him. They took their horses everywhere trying to find him. And they came back to the Prophet ﷺ. They said, he's nowhere. The Prophet ﷺ said, do you know who that was? They said, no. He said, that was Jibreel coming to teach you your religion. Even the wording of the Prophet ﷺ, he wasn't coming to teach me. He was coming to teach you, because he knows how you guys pay attention when questions are being asked. And so he asked the most important and essential questions, and he succeeded, because it's the most important hadith in Islam.